Hello, my name is Sven and I am from Reviews by Super Sven.
Hello, I am Simone.
Today we are going to do an unboxing of Journey to Acrea. This is a board game that will release most likely next year and it is currently in Kickstarter. I have one of the few prototypes here and we are going to play this game, but for now we are just going to check what's inside the box. As you can see, it has no official packaging yet. It's just a box with content. But what's inside it? Let's see.
We have a note.
Let's see. Thank you very much for checking our game out. Please take into account that this is a handmade prototype. It does not reflect the final quality and designs are subjected to changes. We'd love to hear your feedback about any part of Journey to Acrea. Please feel free to reach out to us if you have any kind of feedback. We'd love to improve as much as we can. If it's possible for you, we would really appreciate it if there was any form of video content included in your review that we can share, so we can share it in our upcoming Kickstarter campaign. We wish you a wonderful week and a fun experience. Now, let's see. We've got bubble wrap! Okay, that's the bubble wrap. Let's see. We also got air! I'm very happy with air. Now, let's see, we have reached the real content. Now, let's see, what do we have here? I see some dice, and I see some cards. Now, let's see, we've got, I think it's an enemy token or a character token. And there are
It's a lady with a sword.
We've got some cards here. And it has a spinning wheel, and it seems it's for defense. You can spin the card, and then it increases or decreases the defense, and the same for an attack card. Now, let's see. I think this is the card that goes with the lady that we just found. It looks the same.
She's a bit bigger, though.
Yeah, it's a shield breaker, and it seems that it has 4 attack, 5 defense, and I think the other is magic or healing. Now, let's see, another card for attacking.
Just in case you play it with more people.
I really hope there are some rules or something somewhere, because I have no idea. Now, there are more cards. There's a lizard guy. And we have more, like a warlock mage thingy. It says hero card, so maybe that's the hero. You have also have a hero of light who looks like an elf with horns.
One is broken.
Yes, and now let's see what else inside. More attack cards and another attack card.
Did you see one that you would like to play?
I first want to find the hero tokens. We've got more defense cards and
I like this one. Probably gonna choose the
we've got more tokens.
Dunmarful. I don't know.
Dunmarful Reds.
Something like that.
We've got more tokens here. We've got the guy with the broken horn as well.
Oh, there's my guy.
And let's see, we have a round token. I'm not sure what this means in the game or how you're going to use it. So I really hope there's an explanation somewhere. And we've got more tokens. And even more tokens.
They look quite nice.
It looks pretty good. I think it looks like a centaur. It's just
yes. It's definitely.
It's a centaur. Now we've got more dice. Normal dice, not Dungeons and Dragon dice.
We could always take some from our Dungeons and Dragons set.
Yeah, I'm not. It all depends on the rules. We got some fishies here, and then small tokens. I'm not sure what they are for. They are
maybe
very small.
Maybe to remember who you are.
Yes. Oh, look what we have here. I think this is the world map that you can create. These are pieces of the map that you can create. Because in this game you need to journey to the top of the mountain, and it seems you can put it together in any way that you like. There are quite a different ones. This one has a question mark.
It says end on the back.
Maybe it's the final place. Maybe you're supposed to use this one for the final boss of the game. More question marks.
They're numbered.
Yeah, I see they're numbered. This one also has a camp. Maybe it's somewhere you can rest. Now let's see, what do we have here? Okay, I have diamonds. I'm rich. It's a whole bag of diamonds. I don't know how you're going to use this. Maybe it's like currency or something, like gold.
Yeah, that's a good option.
Oh, look, we've got one lost gold. We got a huge set of cards here. Now, let's see. I think this might be enemy cards.
The one on top says boss.
It's a boss. And these are boss cards. And let's see, we also have event cards. For example, this event card is a forgotten shrine. It says you kneel down and pray to your deity. Your element decides which effects happen for all heroes. There are all kinds of different elements, but you can be healed or remove status effects. You can will advance one field or go back one field. Or you all need to discard a hand card of choice, or you all lose health or gain gold. There are even more events. There are a lot of event cards. And I think the Dungeon Master will have to make a nice chat about what kind of event goes down and how it all will work. Now, cursed relics, thunderstorms, tainted magic, battle of wits, freezing down power, a rock slide. Oh no, you got hit by a rock slide, you're dead, game over. Now, let's see, we have more cards here. And it seems we've got armor. You got heavy armor, you've got some weapons. The art looks very nice. This is a spell. And it seems remove all damage and counters defense. Your sight gets sharper, your hearing gets better. You're ready for the hunt. Let's look, this one isn't drawn in yet. Or is it supposed to be like that?
I don't know.
Kiss of the Dryad. Maybe they are going to add another graphic for that. You have a blessing or a curse. You have daggers and let's see, armor for gloves, hats, combat spells with daggers, and a lot more. A lot of cards, so there's probably a lot of replay value, as you most likely won't get the same cards over. As you can see, it is a huge stack of cards. And we have...
What's all about this one? Or what's that?
Let's see, this is preparation. You can prepare for a fight. And depending on your element, you either get +1, +2, or +3 attack. And if you have a certain element, you can't use it, and you need to discard the card and draw a treasure. You also have some blasts. There are a lot, and I do mean a lot of cards. It's... Yeah,
it's a small stack.
Deerskin gloves, Daybreak.
It sure looks very promising.
I really hope there's an instruction on how to play the game, because
I'm not sure yet.
Well, we're going to have to dig deeper into the box.
Well, it's not like we ever played a tutorial of a game.
No, we always skip that.
Yeah, that's basically how we do all games.
Now, let's see.
This could have pulled a piece of instruction manual at some time. What do you have there?
We have more cards!
What kind of cards?
Let's see. Oh, I've got them wrong. It seems these are wildlife cards, and sites, meetings, crossroads, runes, caves, and some mercenaries. This says a wildlife woodkin. Thorny vines ensnare you and bite into your skin. This creature strikes you before you even have a chance to attack. Compare its attack to your defense and you lose health accordingly. If you stay conscious, fight it after. Glowing cavern. Now let's see, I think there's even more cards.
We need a bigger table.
We need a huge table! Now let's see, these are a bit scattered all over the place. The Mourner and a Snapping Snarler.
Is it more wildlife?
Yes, we've got a wrestler. It looks like a zombie.
Please add it to my stack.
Let's see, we have more tokens here, small tokens. This one says +1 defense. It's really small, so you probably can't see it.
I don't know what this one does.
It seems like a poison. And this is a question mark.
Basically nobody knows yet.
And we've got another token. And we've got... Well,
it actually looks like a drop of poison, now you mentioned it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look, this one looks like it's still it's going to get replaced with other graphic. It's a webbing mother and it's a wildlife spider.
You can see it's a spider.
Yes,
I wouldn't want that on the ceiling above my bed.
Nope. Now, let's see. We've got even more cards!
Lots of wildlife.
The Restless Horror.
It's a little bit lower.
Looks really creepy. And let's see, some meetings, a cave. more mercenaries and restless zombies, bandits, another site. This is a Wood Witch Lodge, a watchtower, loads of
cards. Oh, a token fell on the ground.
Plus one defense token.
Thank you.
Now, we have even more cards and a blank card. Now,
that's for the question mark.
Now we've got some.
Where should I?
Put it somewhere with all the other stuff.
Let's put it with the wildlife.
Here's another plus one attack token. It's not defense this time.
Oh, our first.
And another drop of poison. And we have another stack of cards. More caves, outcast sites. They all do something differently. So every playtime should be different. A burial site. Another token, but this one says min one defense.
Can I give it back?
Let's see, a rotting old bridge, and there are certain options, an agitated howler cup, a river bend, a skeletal sentry, an acid mire, another howler. Look, more cards.
Thank you.
We've got a whole bag of small tokens.
Should we add
We can put them in there. We have another.
We'll do that after the video.
Yes, we have another loose token here, and let's see.
Bleeding damage. Yeah. Or another poison.
Or health. Let's see, what do we have here?
I don't know.
It's.
Oh, you can place your tokens here, and plus one defense, poison.
It's like an inventory screen. Press E to open inventory and put down. You can place it on your table, and then you can use it to equip items.
Bigger tables are not included.
And we also have weapons here, and another weapon, and token slots, and more weapon slots, and another one, and another one, and more. You might need a lot for if you play with more people. Let's see, a rule book! Huzzah! Attention, this part of the rule book is still under construction.
Happy smiley face.
Let's see. Well, before we are going to play the real game, we are going to need to take a look into this book. But for now, let's see if there is some information that I can share with you. The objective of the game is to move your hero to the final field on the board where the Forgotten City lies and defeat the boss you meet there. The player who manages to defeat the boss first wins the game. There are camps also in the field, and they are marked with tents.
Tents are marked with tents.
The camps are marked with tents. There are 8 hero tokens, 20 life counters, 20 poison counters, 4 dice, 10 camp/event tokens, 40 lasting effect counters, arcane energy counters, 8 hero cards, 75 treasure cards, 75 encounter cards, 3 boss cards, 15 event cards, 4 player boards. And as I thought, the player board is indeed the inventory. Now let's see. Well, here's how the cards work and what elements they do. Now, of course, you need to have a game master, but if I am correct, this game uses game masters by switching the role. Let's see. example, the game master could say something, or you make a story, and then after the game master is done, it is the turn of the game master, and then the other person becomes the game master, so everyone gets to be the game master. The gameplay also has multiple phases in each turn. You start with a drawing phase, then there's a dawn phase, a travel phase, a dusk phase, and an end phase. Now, every phase has, it's all explained in the book, so we are going to need to read that carefully before making a video of playing the game. Let's see, yes, the
basics are explained.
Yes, like what the gold thingies are, that's actually arcane energy.
It's not gold.
Nope, the white are cleansed energy and the black is corrupted energy. The charges depend on your hero element. Now it's also explained how you have a fight in this game and when you win and lose. Now there's also how the boss fight works and if you can flee, if you can help all the heroes, if you are unconscious. And there are also some additional rules. And there is more of the, some of the book is still in the construction, which will come later.
Once again with a happy smiley face.
Yes.
Oh, another smiley face.
They like smiley faces. Well, that's it. The box is empty.
Let's place a cat in it.
Yes, we have enough cats for that. Well, I thank you for watching. We will make a screenshot and show you exactly on the table what is there. And I hope you enjoyed this unboxing video and are excited to see us play the game.
We sure are.
Yes, I definitely want to play the game, especially because I want the inventory menu. Well, thank you for watching and I hope you are going to look at the Kickstarter and maybe back them, because if they have more backers, they can make even more cards. Yay! Thank you for watching. Bye.